Good morning, class 12th, and today we are going to start the chapter number 11, that is alcohol, phenol and ether, which belongs to the organic chemistry part or part 2 book. Fine. So as all of us we know that whenever there is a hydrogen atom of hydrocarbon replaced by one atom or group of atom, then there is the formation of a new compound whose properties are completely different from the hydrocarbon. So when there is a hydrogen replaced by the hydroxyl derivative, then it is to be formed alcohol. ठीक है, तो hydrocarbon या alkane का H जब replace होगा OH से तो क्या बनाएगा, alcohol बनाएगा. Similarly, if there is a hydrogen of aromatic hydrocarbon like benzene is replaced by the OH group, then it is to be formed phenol. As you can see here that this is a benzene C6H6 from which one hydrogen attached to the carbon is replaced by OH group and it forms phenol C6H5OH. Fine beta. And whenever there is a replace or substitution of alkoxy group OR group in hydrocarbon and replaces one hydrogen, then it is to be formed ether. ठीक है, क्या बनाते हैं, ether ROR. Similarly, when aromatic hydrocarbon hydrogen is replaced by your arene group or we can say that is aryloxy group, इसको हम क्या बोलेंगे, aryloxy group, then it is to be formed ether in the aromatic compound. ठीक है, तो AROAR. There are the very great uses we can find in our day to day life and in the industry, these compounds like alcohol, phenol and ether. So for example, agar hum baat karte hain the spirit which is required for your polishing the wooden furniture, so that is basically spirit that consists of hydroxyl group and that is ethanol basically. Jo main hamara jise hum common alcohol bhi kehte hain, that ethanol is used to polish the wooden furniture. Similarly, the sugar which we eat or the cotton which is used for the fabrics or the paper which we use for writing or are all made up of the compounds which contain hydroxyl group. So agar hum baat kar rahe hain ki there is no life without paper, no notebooks, books, newspapers, currency notes, checks, certificates, etc., magazines which is having a so beautiful colored photographs with interesting stories, so that will not be there if there is no alcohol. So the alcohol is very very important compound which we are going to study in detail. So agar humne baat kari ki hydrocarbon mein se jab hydrogen nikla to kya bana, alcohol. Aromatic hydrocarbon mein se जब आपका एक हाइड्रोजन रिप्लेस हुआ हाइड्रोक्सिल डेरिवेटिव से या हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप से तो आपका फिनॉल बना. एंड सिमिलरली व्हेन हाइड्रोकार्बन हाइड्रोजन इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय एल्कोक्सी या एराइलोक्सी ग्रुप, देन इट इज फॉर्मिंग ईथर. ओके, नाउ वी मूव टू द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ योर व्हाट ऑफ alcoholic group. ठीक है, so अगर हम classification की बात करते हैं, so the classification will be first done on the basis of mono, di or tri or polyhydric compounds. ठीक है बेटा, so इनके basis पे किया जाता है. Like for example, if the ethanol is having one hydroxyl group, then it is it comes under the category of monohydric. If it carries two hydroxyl group, then it is di. If it is having a three hydroxyl group like this one, CH2OH, CH2OH and CH2OH, then this will be considered as the trihydric alcohol. Similarly, in the case of aromatic compounds also, in aromatic, if there is a one hydroxyl, then it will be considered as monohydric. If there are two hydroxyl group or two ol group present in the aromatic compound, then it is to be considered as dihydric. Aise hi agar aapke aromatic hydrocarbon mein ya benzene mein, if there is a presence of three hydroxyl group, then it is to be considered as trihydric and so on. So we can classify monohydric alcohols further on the basis of hybridization of carbon atom to which hydroxyl group is attached, and on that basis we can categorize it further into two types. Pehla, that the compounds which contain carbon to which hydroxyl group is attached, that is sp3 hybridized. Dobara dhyan se suniye beta, pehli category hogi jisme ki the carbon in which hydroxyl group is present, that is sp3 hybridized, and the second category, the compounds which contains carbon attached to the hydroxyl group is a sp2 hybridized. So the compounds which contain carbon having sp3 hybridized hydroxyl group attached to the carbon sp3 hybridized, that is further categorized into the primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols on the basis of the carbon into which hydroxyl group is attached, whether that carbon is primary or secondary or tertiary. ठीक है? So like this one carbon is having a one alkyl group, so it is to be considered as primary alcohol. ठीक है? ये क्या है? Primary alcohol है. इस carbon पर देखिए बेटा, there are two alkyl groups, one hydrogen is present and one hydroxyl group is present. So because of the presence of two alkyl group present or attached to the carbon in which hydroxyl group is there, so it is to be considered as the secondary alcohol. और इस वाले कार्बन को अगर हम देखते हैं, so in this one there are three alkyl groups attached to the carbon in which hydroxyl group is there, and that's why this alcohol is to be considered as the tertiary alcohol. ठीक है? Next is about the allylic alcohols. So obviously, as we have already talked about the allylic hydrocarbon in our haloalkane and halorine chapter also. So allylic alcohols mein the hydroxyl group attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon, which is next to the carbon double bond carbon. So that carbon, this carbon is to be considered as the allylic carbon. कहने का मतलब ये है बेटा, जिस कार्बन पर हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप लगा है उसका नेक्स्ट कार्बन जो होना चाहिए वो डबल बॉन्डेड होना चाहिए. ठीक है? सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एंड दैट कैन बी फर्दर कैटेगराइज्ड इवन ऑल्सो इन प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शरी. आई जस्ट शो इट टू यू हाउ, लाइक दिस वन कार्बन इज हैविंग अ डबल बॉन्ड एंड दिस कार्बन नेक्स्ट टू दिस carbon hydroxyl group is present. Now this carbon is having one alkyl group, so it is to be considered as primary. Is carbon pe jis pe hydroxyl group hai uska next carbon double bonded hai, aur is carbon par aapke do alkyl group hai, one is this, second is this, so it is to be considered as secondary alcohol, secondary allylic alcohol. In this one case, this carbon is having a hydroxyl group and the next to this is having a double bond, as well as this carbon is having a three alkyl group. How? 1, 2 and 3. So it is to be considered as 3-degree or tertiary alcohol, tertiary allylic alcohol. Next category इसी में आ जाती है बेटा आपकी, benzylic alcohols. Now in these alcohols basically hydroxyl group attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon atom which is next to an aromatic ring. ठीक है? तो किस में आएगा? Aromatic ring के जो next carbon है उस पर hydroxyl group होगा. तो उस carbon पर, उस carbon की hybridization कितनी होनी चाहिए? sp3. क्योंकि अगर aromatic ring पे अगर hydroxyl group attached है तो वो carbon double bonded होंगे सारे के सारे, और वहां sp2 hybridized हो जाएगा. ठीक है? So in this one, like for example, this is the case of benzene ring, and the another one carbon, this is sp3 hybridized. ठीक है, and further this carbon is 1 degree because it is having only one group. यही वाला benzyl group, या ये आपका ring, aromatic ring एक ही attached है, तो this is 1 degree. In this one case, this carbon is sp3 hybridized. How? Because in this one, this is next to the aromatic ring. One hydroxyl group is here and one alkyl group is here. So because there are two groups, alkyl groups, yeah, one aryl and one alkyl group is present here. So this carbon is known as the secondary alcohol, secondary benzylic alcohol. Similarly, in this one case, as you can see, there aromatic ring is present. Next to this aromatic ring, a carbon in which hydroxyl group is there, and two alkyl group, one aryl group is present in this one sp3 hybridized carbon. So this is tertiary alcohol. Okay, next aa jati hai beta second category hai hamari, that is the compounds which containing carbon sp2oh bond. So this is very easy. In this one, hydroxyl group attached to the carbon double bond carbon, and such a carbon are known as vinylic carbon. अगर आपका कार्बन sp3 है और उस जिस पर हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप है और उसका नेक्स्ट कार्बन डबल बॉन्डेड है, तो वो अलाइलिक कार्बन होगा, अलाइलिक एल्कोहल होगा. और अगर कार्बन sp2 हिब्रिडाइज्ड है जिस पर हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप प्रेजेंट है, सो वो आपके विनाइलिक एल्कोहल्स होंगे. लाइक इन दिस वन केस द CH2 डबल बॉन्ड CH, एंड इन दिस sp2 हिब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन hydroxyl group is present. So this is a vinylic alcohol. Similarly, phenols are also the comes under this category, because the in phenol, the carbon in which hydroxyl group is attached to the aromatic ring, that is also sp2 hybridized. ठीक है, so ये phenol हो गए, ये आपके methyl phenols हो गए. These also comes under the category of the vin. Next beta, we come up to the classification of phenols. So phenols are generally classified. It is the simplest hydroxy derivative of benzene, or that is known as phenol. इसे हम क्या कहते हैं? Phenol कहते हैं. Or in its common name, and also it is accepted as IUPAC naming. ठीक है, इसी को IUPAC naming भी कहते हैं. Or as a structure of phenol, it involves a benzene ring. तो अगर इसकी सेकेंड कार्बन पर हो रहा है, तो 1-2 को आपको मालूम ही है ऑर्थो बोलते हैं, 1-3 को हम मेटा बोलते हैं, और 1-4 को हम क्या बोलते हैं? पैरा बोलते हैं. सो सिमिलरली, अगर आपका मिथाइल ग्रुप इज प्रेजेंट एट सेकेंड कार्बन, देन इट इज टू बी कंसिडर्ड एज 2-methyl फिनॉल. हियर द मिथाइल ग्रुप इज प्रेजेंट इन द थर्ड वन पोजिशन, सो इट इज कंसिडर्ड एज 3-methyl फिनॉल. एंड हियर the methyl group is present as the fourth one position, so it is to be considered as 4-methyl phenol. Common name is because it is present as 2, so it is orthocrisol. It is present at 3, so it is considered as metacrisol. And the common naming of this one, because it is present at the fourth one position, so it is to be considered as para क्रिसोल. ऐसे ही अगर हम डाई हाइड्रोक्सी डेरिवेटिव ऑफ बेंजीन की बात करें, तो 1-2, 1-3, 1-4 बेंजीन डाइओल करके भी हम इनको नेमिंग कर सकते हैं. लाइक हियर इन दिस वन केस 1 और 2 है, सो बेंजीन 1-2 डाइओल, बेंजीन 1-3 डाइओल, बेंजीन 1-4 डाइओल कहते हैं, जिनके कॉमन नेम है 1-2 डाइओल के कैटाकॉल, 1-3 डाइओल रिसोर्सिनोल, and 1-4 diol benzene 1-4 diol is to be considered as phenol or hydroxyquinone. iski ek naming beta hum kyunki aage compounds mein use karenge, so this is also known as hydroxyquinone. okay, so just learn the common name also of these compounds. and today we have done the IUPAC nomenclature as well as common nomenclature and classification of alcohol and phenol. Thank you.